developed. So hi everyone, my name is Davey and I work for CRYPSYS. We are an IT security company, mainly for enterprises. And I've been working there for the last 3 years, mainly focusing on the topic of user authentication. And it's also something that is very related to what we're going to talk about today, or what my presentation is about today. So, has any one of you heard about the brand Yubico before? It's more than I expected. So, something went wrong here. Just a little bit of the agenda. A short introduction is something that I just want to finish. Then I will talk a little bit about what Yubico do and what kind of problems does it solve. Followed by a live demo on how you can use this specific device to secure your private and public keys, or at least your private keys is the ones that you want to secure, I guess. One more thing is, besides that I work for a company called CRYPSYS, I use my spare time to develop a website. It's called CryptoStart. It's fully in Dutch, but it gives a lot of information about several cryptocurrencies. I write reviews about hardware wallets. I also have like a big overview that displays the worth of several cryptocurrencies, just as CoinMarketCap does, but then a bit more beautiful, I guess. You should check it out. So, does anyone here know the difference between two-factor and multi-factor authentication? Just one guy. So, starting with why would you need something more than just strong authentication is passwords are quite a problem. And as you mentioned before, to have a secure password, it has to be somewhere about 20 characters. And that is a lot, and a bit more than I think most of us can remember, especially if you keep in mind that you shouldn't use the same password for multiple applications or websites at the same time. That is something that has turned out after, for example, LinkedIn, the social network got hacked in 2011, where a lot of people were using, instead of myself, I must admit, were using the same password for their LinkedIn account as they did for their Facebook account, for their Gmail account, etc. What happened is, a big database with all user credentials of LinkedIn got hacked, and that same data was reverse engineered in some way. And therefore, other people's personal accounts got hacked. So, if you had some cryptocurrency back then, it could be quite a problem. One of the main reasons why using a password is also not really secure is they can be phished. So it means if you've got like viruses on your computer or keyloggers, hackers can actually copy the keystrokes that you're making, and therefore copy your passwords and use them again. Another risk of getting the password stolen is having it being guessed or actually brute force. You mentioned 20 characters is a good length for a password, and the main reason for that is if you have a password that is, for example, just 8 characters. These days, a computer can easily try out every possible password combination of 8 characters within just 12 hours. So your password, if it's just 8 characters, can be cracked in just a few hours. So the way we solve that is with a solution that we call strong authentication. And strong authentication, two-factor authentication, is basically the idea of adding something more to your login process than just a username and a password. So it makes it easier or harder for a hacker to get into your account. And there are several ways of using strong authentication. And today we're talking about the solution of Yubikey. So Yubikey is just a small device and it fits on your keychain. And this specific device can be used whenever you log out to any specific application. Just as it could be a password manager, but it could also be your Gmail account, it could be anything. So first of all, you have to just include your username and the password as you normally do. And then this system requires you to stick in. See? You stick in a key in the USB port and press a button. Doesn't sound too hard, but it brings a lot of security with it. So I don't want to dive too too much into the technical details of this little thing, but it is quite an advanced solution. It looks just like a USB stick, but it doesn't do more than that. What you see here is the multiple authentication protocols that we support, and I put this image in the presentation because I wanted to let you know that there are different ways of using strong authentication, even when it is with just one single device. The Yubikey itself, it can be used with quite about anything. You got a question?
No.
Okay. Earlier when Hank was talking, I saw like one third of the topic putting up the hand when asking for a password manager. What kind of password manager are you guys using? Who's using LastPass?
Dashlane.
Good luck. Anyone something like KeePass, password safe? Okay. Got some nice choices there. So this specific device can be used to protect actually any kind of password manager or any kind of application that you want it to protect. But the way it does it is really important actually. So this specific key, this Yubikey key, is being recognized by your computer as just a USB keyboard. So anything that can receive data from a keyboard can integrate with this solution. Before I go on to the demo, we have these keys in multiple formats. So what you could do, for example, is just have to regularly use it for. It is the key that supports all the protocols you need and basically does everything. If you've got specific needs or wishes, you can use another kind of key. So you get nano, it speaks for itself that this device is small, it's nano 4. But you also got a 4C. And then we got the Yubikey Neo, which is used for NFC authentication. So if you've got a smartphone or a tablet or something else that supports NFC, you can also use it to authenticate wireless or get access to your password manager or another application wireless. And then we have to find a new direction. Does anyone know what FIDO B2F is? It is a bit of a technical question. I was hoping just a few guys, some people are using Dashlane, for example. But there are a lot of password managers that natively support the use of Yubikey for a secure login. But the way they have implemented the support for Yubikey is in most of them different. So this little device can be used in multiple ways to securely authenticate yourself. And one of the most secure and most modern ways is FIDO U2F. What FIDO U2F basically does is whenever you stick the YubiKey in a USB port and you have it communicate with an application, it only handles the challenge response between the specific key and a public key that is stored in that specific application. So that means that whenever you use this thing, there is no text, there is no data, there is nothing actually filled in any kind of form. And why would that be handy? So it can't be phished. It can't be stolen, it can't be copied, it can't be intercepted, there's nothing somebody can steal. FIDO-U2F is quite a new protocol, and it is right now supported by, for example, Dashlane and PasswordSafe, I know for sure. It also works with your Google account, it works with your Dropbox, but there are still a lot of applications that don't support it. Plus, if you go to an application that works in your browser, it only works via either Firefox and Google Chrome. Yubico ODB is such another kind of authentication method in which a key is actually being put in some kind of field. Is better? Sorry. I heard myself speaking loud about that. And when you're using the Yubikey OTP authentication, what the Yubikey does is, I think you can actually show it to you. If I get something, where I can type something in, it shouldn't be too hard, I guess.
lost the screen.
So what it does is when you have Yubikey in the USB port and you press the button, it spits out a note, and it looks a bit small on the
zoom into this somehow.
So what you see here is the code that it spits out, if the beginning of this is always the same. And that essentially means that the beginning of this is the unique authentication ID or the unique ID that the Yubikey has. And that gives it the possibility to register a specific key for a specific application. And the way that works is, for example, when you go to, let's say, the password manager, the password manager requires you to use the Yubikey in the USB port. You press the button, and then it spits out the code. And the application itself knows that. Knows that on the first part of this key is the identifier of the key. And therefore, the next time that you log into that specific application, it will ask you to put in the key that corresponds with that ID. And then this part here is a combination of a timestamp, a timestamp, and a OTP that is encrypted and encrypted again. So this is also quite a secure solution, but it is a bit less secure than the IDF, because there is still a possibility that it might fish. But it is always better than just using a username and a password. And then, in one last resort, if you have a specific application that doesn't support anything, so it just supports something like a password, and we've got, for example, I believe for one password that doesn't support two-factor authentication, am I right?
Yeah.
Then you can also configure Yubikey to use a static password. And why would you do that? It could be a way of securing your digital wallet in another way than just a regular password. So this thing can remind a password of 64 characters for you. You can put just the static password on the key, and it will be your password for you. And if you combine it with something that how is it called in the one password? Your master key or something like that? If you combine that with that, with your master key is in one password, it still hides your security. So I will go on to a demo in which I show how you can use the key to secure your private keys. Right here, I've got the exact wallet installed, but it could be any kind of wallet that you want to have. And in this Jax wallet, I'll go to Tools, Backup Wallet, and get it tells me. Just say that I understand what it says. So here it gives me the seed that we're talking about, the seed of 12 different words. And you could store that seed somewhere, split it behind your grandmother's paintings on the wall. You could also save it in your Bitcoin wallet, or in your password manager, or you could save it anywhere. But whenever you use a password manager that is on premises, so it uses a cold store, I think it would be a good idea to, it would be a bad idea to secure your seed as well in your password manager. But I leave it up to you. What I wanted to show you is the way how we can back up our private keys. So if I request my private keys for my Bitcoin wallet, for example, I think you guys can't read it. And I've got to mint this as well. Well, it shows me my public key right here, and my private key is being saved right here. So what I just do is I have to copy these specific keys and save it somewhere in one of my password managers. So for this presentation, I've prepared a password manager that is based on DashSafe and a password manager that is based on password safe. So I go to DashSafe first, and DashSafe here is installed just on my computer, but I think you can also access it via a browser. So I have to put down the Microsoft to type in my password because it's quite long. So if I had just protected my password manager with a username and a password, just enough to get access to my private keys and therefore get access to my Bitcoin funds or my cryptocurrency funds. But this isn't the case. Hello. Sorry. I need an internet connection. Yubikey and give this Yubikey the same configuration as the primary Yubikey. We have a tool for that. You can just download it on the website of Yubico. Let's see. And it's called the Yubikey personalization tool. It's not something special. You just go to the application and you can copy your Yubikey configuration. Most applications, Gmail does it, but I think Gmail does it as well.
If I borrow your key ring, can you use it to make a copy of your Yubikey?
Not exactly. It could be configured to be the same challenge response mechanism. So that is something that you can do. But you can't copy the unique ID of the YubiKey, for example, and you can't copy the seed that is enclosed in the YubiKey. That is because this data is stored in a secure element that is in the YubiKey. I think they use a chip from NXP for that. And I have heard this thing, but I've not verified it. They say that if you try to integrate it, crack the secure element, it self-destructs.
So you can still copy it, but you can still need to add your own seed, your original seed.
Yeah, indeed. But getting back to what happens if you've lost both of your YubiKeys, or you only got one YubiKey, what are you going to do then? Well, most applications support some kind of failover mechanism. And Dash name, for example, does this as well. Just say password again. So, what it says here, use a mobile authenticator instead. When you first enroll your Dash name password manager with strong authentication, it requests if you want to configure some kind of backup authentication method. And one of the backup authentication methods that you can use is a Google Authenticator. Has anyone heard of Google Authenticator? Knows what it is? Okay, so I'll just. So Google Authenticator is one of the most basic forms of user authentication or strong authentication, but it adds a bit more security than just the username and password. And what Google Authenticator does, it is just an application that generates a new time-based code every 30 or 60 seconds. So this is a technology that isn't that secure at all. Actually, if you get like 3, 4, 5 or a few of these codes, you can discover the algorithm in it. But it is a good backup alternative for if you've lost both of your YubiKeys. So what I suggest, what I will suggest is that if you've lost your YubiKey and you are going to have to use this backup authentication method, such as the Google Authenticator, do it once, but as soon as you're logged in, reconfigure this thing for a new seed, for example. So yeah, people can't hack it, people can't discover the algorithm. But it is a safe way of picking it up. So the Dash main password manager is a password manager that is possible to access when you have just username the password and right click to authenticate yourself. That means that it can be accessed by using any device that has access to the internet. So it could also be used from just a strange computer. Going to dashmate.com. If you want to step up your security a bit more, you could use a password manager that is installed locally on our computer. And one of those password managers is password safe. You can see the GUI, the user interface isn't as nice as the dashmate, but I think we're caring a bit more about security than about the GUI right here. So, what password safe does is it requires you to open up a database or generate a specific database that is specifically for your password for. And I have the database here that I made recently. Now I'm going to put in my password once again.
Different one.
Yeah, it's like we got this capital and then low and then capital and then small. because I use a MacBook at home, there are just different people. So, right now, this password is safe. This password is safe. It doesn't tell me anything. It says, okay, I just entered this thing and I'm going to press enter. And then it says, okay, something went wrong. But it could be anything. And that is so that if hackers try to access your password, say, for any kind of reason, they don't get a single clue. Why is this the case? Well, I know why this is the case. It's the outline because I haven't inserted the Yubikey and I have configured this application to work with the Yubikey. So what I'm going to do is do it again. And I think should be asking for this Okay, so what I'm going to do instead to show you that it works is I generate a new database and I call this so I've got this password safe and I can add things like public and private keys in here. And let's say it was the same as before, but I use my private key here. Let's say this is my I'm going to open this password safe. Something else.
Maybe skip it and go to the table.
Okay. So the idea is just the same as when you use the flash name, a password safe, it should be asking you for inserting a Yubikey. And if you've done that, that was actually a demo of the Yubikey authentication. One more thing that I would like to share with you is I mentioned that FIDO U2F is one of the most secure authentication protocols right now. Well, this protocol is also supported by both the Ledger hardware wallet and the Trezor hardware wallet. So you don't necessarily have to buy a Yubikey if you just want to use it for your dash name or your password safe or any other kind of service that uses FIDO to have authentication. If, however, you want to use this thing for any kind of application, any kind of service that protect your whole identity, I think Yubikey would be a great solution. So, if you've got any other questions, I'll be here for the rest of the evening, and of course you can ask the questions now.
What is the price of a Yubikey?
It is 38 euros for the Yubikey 4. If you want to buy the Yubikey Neo, which supports NFC, it is 48. So I think it's something that would be a very big problem.
Is there a particular reason why you use the virtual image?
Yeah, because this is a corporate network, and our IT department has shut off everything. So I can't install anything on my corporate laptop. No applications. I need administrative access for that.
So that's good one.
Now, I have installed well, not Dashpane, but LastPass and another password manager on my private. Anything else, Mike?
So let's be people, hackers, would not steal your YubiKey or whatever, but they would just hack your two-factor authentication.
Yeah, maybe better.
Thank you. So what if people, the hackers, would just hack your two-factor authentication, because that's simpler, and then lock you out of your YubiKey option? Isn't that easier for them to do that? Because you said that's easier to hack.
So how do you imagine that hackers are going to do that?
Well, you mentioned it was easier to hack to
I'm sorry. So you meant that if people are going to hack Google Authenticator, for example?
Yeah.
That's a good question. So that is also why I'm advising, if you have to use the Google Authenticator because you've lost all your Google keys, just use it once. And once you're logged in, you'll be confident.
Sure. This, but they can just try that.
But how are they going to try that?
Let's say they have the rest, and they're just not going to try YubiKey, because you also can enter through the two-factor authentication.
Yeah.
Thinking that there are many ways that you can, again, reset your YubiKey, but those are now the weak links. So now YubiKey is strong, but there are other ways around it.
Yeah.
So it's still...
It is a thing to keep in mind. But I think there should always be a balance between security and usability of a specific solution. And the main reason why a two-factor solution like the Google Authenticator isn't really solid, isn't really secure, is because when you've got multiple codes captured after each other, you can calculate the algorithm. If you only have one specific code, then there is nothing you can calculate. So the only way how you will be able to steal it then is if somebody steals your phone and has to Google Authenticator on it, and that could be one of the things. Or if somebody might guess it, but it's almost impossible to guess, it's almost impossible to guess a 6-digit or an 8-digit code within 30 seconds.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Anyone else? No? Okay. Thanks a lot. And, thank you.